Hello, I'm Dr. Mitchell Schare. I'm professor of psychology at Hofstra University, and I'm the director of the Phobia and Trauma Clinic.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Bruder. I'm an advanced doctoral student in the clinical psychology program here at Hofstra.
At our clinic, we have a specialty program called the Armed Services Adjustment Program. During my training as a clinical psychologist, I had an opportunity to work with veterans and eventually serve an internship at the Providence VA. And it was an opportunity to become a specialist in working with veterans with post-traumatic stress disorder.
The program is really looking to recruit individuals who have been deployed to Iraq or Afghanistan. We're looking for OEF, OIF, OND veterans who have experienced combat and are experiencing difficulties now that they've returned back to civilian life.
At our clinic, we've been using virtual reality technology since about 1998. What we do is exposure therapy, which is a standardized psychotherapy for many, many years for the treatment of all kinds of anxiety disorders. As a specialist in the treatment of post-traumatic stress disorder, I've always been interested in integrating virtual reality technology to this particular problem.
It's a nice way of trying to get at veterans who feel uncomfortable with kind of typical talk therapy. So we're working with people who may have had experiences in gaming or who feel more comfortable with today's technology and really helping them come into treatment with that in mind.
The world of virtual reality is going in two directions. One direction right now is the ability to collect a video in a 360-degree real environment and then integrate people into those real environments. And so the quality of the video will appear much better. The second direction that this technology is going is to what's called augmented reality. And in augmented reality, we would be able to place artificial items into a real environment. So a person who might be scared of spiders, we can actually have them looking at another person and a spider would start crawling from their back across their shoulder. So we'd be able to do that in the future with relevant stimuli for our veterans.
The technology is growing at such a quick rate that I can't even imagine where it's going to be in 10 to 15 years.
We are now merging this new technology into the treatment of PTSD, and I anticipate it too will be a very, very useful and successful treatment for our very brave veterans.